JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for April the 1st. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, as always, let's start with the performance of the dollar against the other G10 currencies. The greenback traded mixed against the other G10s on Tuesday and during the Asian morning Wednesday. It gained against the Kiwi, the Aussie, and slightly against the Swiss franc, while it underperformed versus SEC, NOK, CAD, JPY, and the pound in that order. The greenback was found virtually unchanged against the euro. Now, the weakening of the risk-linked currencies Aussie and Kiwi, combined with the strengthening of the safe haven yen, suggests that the first quarter of 2020 closed with a risk of flavor. Looking at equities, we see that EU indices continued to gain, perhaps due to investors rebalancing their portfolios. Remember, yesterday we noted that those who sold stocks heavily due to the fast spreading of the coronavirus may have been buying back some, which they believe they've become cheap enough. However, the picture was different during the US and Asian sessions. Despite the Fed's announcement that it would broaden the ability of other central banks to exchange their holdings of US Treasuries for overnight dollar loans, all three of Wall Street's main indices closed in negative waters. You can see here Dow, S&P, and Nasdaq closed in negative territory, with the risk aversion rolling into the Asian session today. The Japan's Nikkei, China's Shanghai Composite, and Hong Kong's Hang Seng were down 4.44, 0.32, and 2.39% respectively. Now, the switch back to risk off at the turn of the quarter enhances our view not to trust the long-lasting recovery in the broader investor morale. New infected cases and deaths due to the coronavirus have hit new records yesterday. You can see here the daily cases and deaths. This is a graph pointing the deaths and cases in day by day basis. And you can see that yesterday we've hit new record highs, which suggests that the worst is not behind us yet. The lockdown in most nations around the globe may last longer than previously anticipated, which may deepen the economic wounds. In our view, it would be naive to assume that the virus saga is already priced in. Thus, we repeat for the umpteenth time that we see decent chances for equities to trade south and for safe havens to shine again. The dollar could also put back its safe haven suit, but we don't expect it to strengthen at the pace it did recently, from March 9th until the 20th of the month. The reason for that is the Fed's attempts to increase the supply of greenbacks around the globe in order to support the smooth functioning of the financial markets. Now, as for the data, yesterday we got Eurozone's preliminary CPIs for March. The headline rates slid more than anticipated to 0.7% year-over-year from 1.2%, while the forecast was for a decline to 0.8%. The core rate slid as well to 1% from 1.2%. No forecast was available for the core print. The euro drifted somewhat lower in the aftermath of the release, perhaps as the data increased speculation for more easing by the ECB. Or it could also be due to a broader dollar strength during the European session yesterday. Now, on March 23rd, Governing Council member Ignacio Visco said that the adopted measures are sufficient and effective, but he and his colleagues stand ready to do more if necessary. So having that in mind, as well as the disappointing PMIs for March, slowing inflation may indeed have increased the chances for further stimulus by the ECB. Officials may decide to increase the size of their bond purchases or even cut the deposit rate further into the negative territory. Although the former appears more likely, with the bank's chief Christine Lagarde saying that there are no limits to our commitment to the euro, we cannot totally rule out the latter. Now, overnight, the Bank of Japan released its Tankan survey for the first quarter. Both the large manufacturers and non-manufacturers indices fell into the negative territory, suggesting that economic activity may have shrunk during the first 3 months of 2020. Following the contraction in the fourth quarter of 2019, this increases notably the chances for a technical recession in the world's third largest economy and enhances the case for more stimulus by the Bank of Japan. Now, as for today's events, we get the final market PMIs from the Eurozone, the UK and the US, but as it is usually the case, expectations are for confirmations of the initial estimates. Investors may pay more attention to the US ISM manufacturing index for the month, which is expected to have declined to 45 from 50.1. In the US, the ADP employment report for March is also coming out. Expectations are for a decline of 154K following a 183K increase in February. Now, coming on top of the astonishing surge in initial jobless claims for the week ended on March 14th, this could raise speculation that the NFPs due out on Friday may also reveal a tumble. Now, with regards to the energy market, we get the Energy Information Administration report on crude oil inventories for last week. Expectations are for a 4 million barrels inventory build following a 1.6 million increase the week before. That said, bearing in mind that overnight, the American Petroleum Institute reported a 10.5 million barrels increase, we see the risks surrounding the Energy Information Administration forecast as tilted to the upside. If this is the case, both WTI and Brent prices could trade lower. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock a.m. GMT time. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye from me. Have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT. Just fair and direct.